Thank you very much for giving us this wonderful opportunity. It has been a dream come true for a person like me to interact with a gigantic musician of a Himalayan stature like Dr. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy, he has been in the field of Carnatic music for over 7 decades. So you can see how many changes he might have seen, how many musicians he might have interacted with, how many millions of audience he has flooded with his mesmerizing voice and music. Apart from all that, I consider Nedunuri Krishnamurthy garu as an epitome of several wonderful components that make a good musician. What makes a good musician? In my opinion, what makes a good musician is what the qualities Nedunuri garu has that makes a good musician. And the qualities he has, the number one is adherence to tradition. He does not deflect, deviate, divert, digress from tradition at any point of time. I have seen him, I have known him for more than 30 years now. And I found there are umpteen number of characteristics in him. He is humble, he is unassuming, he is a person with great caliber in music, and I have heard his music for several years. And to be very honest with you and give you a secret, he is the only musician from Andhra who has been singing in music academy for 55 years continuously. In music academy, normally they don't let anybody continuously sing for 2 years or more than 3 years, because what happens is they've established themselves. We don't want anybody to establish themselves. We want to give opportunities to newer people. But even when his concerts are at 10 o'clock on a working day, 10 o'clock in the morning on a working day, the auditorium is always overflowing with audience. This is because of many qualities. Number one is adherence to tradition. Number two, he comes from the Tyagaraja parampara. Tyagaraja's shishya is Valajapeta Venkatramana. Tyagaraja has 3 distinct schools of disciples. One is Valajapeta school, another is Tilaisthanam school, the third one is Umayalpuram school. Out of the Valajapeta people have their own records of Tyagaraja's compositions. There are patantaras between this school and that school. But what is very important is Valajapeta retains most of the gamakas and sangatis and nuances of the music of Tyagaraja. And Valajapeta Venkatramana's disciple is Mysore Sadashiva Rao. His disciple is Lakshmana Rao.
Karigir Rao.
Karigir Rao's disciple is Mysore Lakshmana Rao. Mysore Lakshmana Rao's disciple Sripada Pinakapani. Sripada Pinakapani's disciple is Nedunuri Krishnamurthy. So you can trace him to Tyagaraja. And it is very peculiar that a musician, I mean, all musicians sing, all musicians, vocalists perform. What is the difference between them and Nedunuri? Why do we need to have a conversation with him? Why not with somebody else? Because there's nobody like Nedunuri. Why Nedunuri? Why nobody is like Nedunuri? Because he has been working in government music colleges as principal in Hyderabad, in Vijayawada, in Tirupati. Tirupati had the wonderful opportunity of singing in the sanctum in front of the Lord several times. We don't have time. We are not allowed to see even the God for 2 minutes. He sits there and sings songs, 10, 15, 20 songs at a time. So is he not special? He is. That's the reason why we are talking to him today. That's not the only reason why we talk to him today. There are so many things that he has done. In our conversation, I'm going to talk to him about, there are 4 or 5 things that he has done that the other musicians did not do. One, he has composed music for Annamacharya's compositions. Annamacharya 1408, 1503, set to have other 32,000 compositions, out of which we get 14,238 available, of which 12,000 are Sringaras and Kirtanas, more than 2,000, close to 2,300 are Adhyatma Sankirtanas. And these were hidden in copper plates in the Sankirtanala Bandaram. And Chaga Annamaya says, Vakka Sankirtane Chalu Uddhikayamam Rakshimpaka Takkinave Bandarana Dachi Undani. He locked it them himself. And so for 500 years until 1822, until A.D. Campbell wanted to see what is there in this Sankirtanala Bandaram, nobody knew that there are some copper plates inside. And later on, when the TTD has taken it out in 1933, they have entrusted it very fortunately for us, for the Telugu people, for the people of the entire peninsular India, and for those people who love Carnatic music, they have entrusted to a man of great integrity, Veturi Prabhakara Shastra. Pratasmaranayilu antam vallam Telugu. We need to worship some people in the early morning. And Veturi Prabhakara Shastri belongs to that category of personalities. He has taken these out 1933. They have washed, cleaned the copper plates, gold-coated them. But how to sing them? There is no Shishya Parampara. There is no tradition of singing Annamacharya songs. Here and there is one song, there is two songs. And every mother, without knowing whose composition it is, sings the lullaby that all of us know, Jo Achyutananda, Jo Jo Mukunda. Without knowing that it is his poem, we also sing this poem, Chetavenna Mudda Chengalva Pudanda Bangar Malataadu Pattu Datti Sandatayatilunu Sarimuva Gajjalu Chini Krishna Nennu Cheri Kolutu Annamayya's composition. So these wonderful compositions have to be tuned by wonderful, no less than a wonderful musician. There are umpteen number of musicians who wanted to, the minute the compositions have been taken out and published into 29 volumes, scholars from literature wanted to see the lyrical beauties in these compositions. Musicians wanted to see what is the rhythm, what is the music, what are the names of the ragas embedded in them. Dancers wanted to see what are the facets in these compositions that will give them scope for dance. Sculptors wanted to see how to chisel sculpture out of it. Paintings, artists, several people of different areas. Philosophers wanted to see what is the kind of philosophy Annamacharya has taught us. And he says very beautifully, Inni tiliyaneela inta chaduvaganeela kannu terachutokati kannu mooyutokati. Telisite moksham tiliyakunte bandham. And all of you know this wonderful song, Nanati bratuku natakam, Kanaka kannadi kaivalyam. Puttutainism, povutainism, nattanadime pani natakam. Yatta yaduta galadi vaikunthamu, kattakadapadi kaivalyam. These are the kind of compositions. And this one composition, Nanati bratuku natakam, brought him Sangeet Kalani, the title. This one composition. I would like to ask him first, how is that one Nanati Bhattuku Natakamu got you Sangeet Kalanidhi?
Let me begin. Respected Provost Vice Chancellor, Professor Hari Babu, former Dean Professor Mohan Ramanan, who belongs to Dikshitar lineage, and head of the department dance, Professor Chonaragadda, Anuradha, and Sri Betavolu Ramabrahmangaru, a great scholar in Telugu. My very good friend, Sri N. Krishnamohan Garu, a philanthropist. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Pappu Garu also a gigantic personality. You must see, he is very tall. A great scholar in Telugu. Telugu is very important. Language is very important for a musician. Some musicians will say, music is great, Telugu is not important for music. But I say, Telugu is, language is very important. to express one's thoughts, emotions, and the sentiments. And there are so many messages were given by our great Vagyekaras. So, Sangeetam Atmanandani Stundi, Sahityam Atma Jnana Nistundi. So both are very important. Atma Jnanam is the final stage for anybody. That Nanati Bratku, Natakam, because Subbalakshmi liked that song, she herself told once, "Sir, this one tune is enough for you to give Sangeet Kalanidhi." And similarly, at that time when they confer Sangeet Kalanidhi, a veteran musician, a Bhishmacharya, Sammungadi has proposed my name and Subbalakshmi has seconded that. That event in my life I can never forget. And it was not happened such an event in the music academy, history of music academy, they say. So like that, Nanadi Bratku Natakam brought me Sangeet Kalanidhi.
Nanati Bratku Natakamu brought you Sangeet Kalanidhi, but do you know the history of how Annamacharya has taken over? In fact, Nedunuri is possessed by Annamacharya. You find oka pona counter chudandi, Annamacharya poonindi ayaniki.
And it was God's grace. Actually, to be frank, I was not interested to render music to Annamacharya songs.
Actually, what happened is, Kamisetu Srinivasulu was in charge of Annamacharya project those days. He has given him this song, Emoko Chiguruta Dharamuna Yadanada Kasturi Nindenu Vamini Vibhunaku Vrasina Patrika Kadukada Kaliki Chako Rakshiki Kadakanulu Kempai Sokina Cheluvam Vipudi Emoko Chintimpare Chelulu Naluvana Praneshwarupai Natina Vagatsupulu Niluvana Peruka Gantina Netturu Kadukada. This kind of poetry is unique in Telugu literature, not just in Telugu literature, anywhere in the world. The reason why I say this is, see, this man, Annamacharya, writes about a redness in the eyes of the concert of Venkateshwara. Alimelumanga, there is bleeding in her eyes. That's what he says. Why are they bleeding? He says because she has to forcibly take away the vision, the glances that she was looking at Venkateshwara. She has to forcibly take it away from him. If you remove glances forcibly, will there be blood in the eyes? That is the poetic value of this particular song. This was the song Kamisetu Srinivasulu gave him. And Annamacharya did not want Nedunuri to tune this song without going deep into the song. So he kept the song aside for 3 months, 4 months, 5 months. And then suddenly he looked at the song and he found, this is a wonderful song, why did I not tune it? And how did you tune it into Tilang, sir? Just tell us about that.
The inspiration has come from God itself, that much I can say. Because I never sung that Tilang Ragam in my concerts. I don't have any idea about that Ragam. Nenu eppudu paadaledu aa Ragam. In that Raga, somehow I asked the Lord Venkateshwara, what is the Raga you suggest? You believe or not, he himself suggested that raga. You sing that song in this raga. One great, that particular raga is popular in light music also. In fact, it is popular more in light music than the classical music. In Hindustani style, this raga is very popular. They sing more bhajans and so many items. But in Karnataka, we don't listen to that raga. Very rarely artists will sing. In that particular raga, how he suggested to tune this song, perhaps he himself wanted to listen to this song in that raga. That much I can say. So then I tuned it. Till now, no one has changed the raga for that song. That is exactly.
Not only that, I think what happened is, because Annamacharya's compositions, there is a merit, there is a demerit. That Annamacharya compositions are not tuned. Because of that, every musician wants to tune it in their own tunes, in their own ragas. And so the same song may be set in different ragas by different musicians. But one composition, if it has to survive, it has to stand the test of time. And that is the reason why when Nedunuri garu started tuning songs, between us I will tell you something else. Out of these 14,000 songs I told you, about 1,300-1,400 songs are tuned till day. Not all the 14,000 are tuned yet. Out of these 14,000 songs, maybe about 200 songs are popular. 1,400 songs, 14,000 songs, 1,400 songs are tuned. Out of that, about 140 or 150 are popular. Now, if you look at the people who composed music, I will say one thing that I have realized, that you know, Sripada Pinakapani is guru, the Doyen centenary, he is 100 years old, a legendary who is still surviving amidst us. It's a great fortune that we have him with us. And he has in fact given Sangeeta Bhiksha to Andhra Desh.
Because
you take four stalwarts in Andhra, in Carnatic music, Nedunuri, Nukala, Srirangam Gopalratnam, Polet Venkatesh. All the four are disciples of Sripada Pinakapani. That one thing is enough to make, you know, understand the strength of his guru on him. And because of that, Sripada Pinakapani tuned many compositions of Annamacharya, Nedunuri tuned many compositions of Annamacharya, his guru, himself, and his sishyas. Balakrishna Prasad is one of his disciples. Malladi brothers are his disciples. Malladi Suri Babu is a disciple of both Sripada Pinakapani, Oleti Venkateswarlu, and also Nedunuri Krishnamurthy.
No.
So between them, not very much. No, he did not learn from you.
No.
He did not learn.
Suri Babu are only Oleti.
Oleti and Sripada Pinakapani. He claims Sripada Pinakapani.
Yeah.
Out of the 1400 songs, about 1000 songs are done by either he or his gurus or his colleagues or his disciples. That is how these songs are done. But I would like to begin with a particular song that you are very fond of. In Bahudari, Master Garu, Nedunuri Garu has composed Sakala Shanti Karamu Sarvesha Nipai Bhakti. Will you just enlighten us about this particular song and why you chose that particular ragam and render a few lines?
About the meaning and the poetic excellence, you must tell, I am not competent. Just I will sing that song. As I told you, every raga was suggested by Lord Venkateswara himself. There is no exaggeration. And he himself sang from here. That's all. My good fortune is any song I want to render it in pure traditional classical music only. I won't deviate. Actually, to survive any art, it must become an education. Art every day it will change. But if science also is added to that art, if you make it education, that will stand forever. So in that aspect, I view any song, if I take it, how far it is suitable for classical tune. In my opinion, every song is suitable for classical music, to set music classic, in classical music. It depends upon the artist's view. And a light music artist will say this is suitable for light music. But in my view, all the compositions he has got a tremendous classical bhava inside. But unfortunately, we do not know how he sang. And another important aspect I want to say. Annamacharya songs they have brought different dimensions of raga which are in within me. In particular, only one raga I have tuned a number of compositions, particularly in Kamas, 10 songs with a difference, with a lot of different dimensions I have tuned. So there is a lot of manodharma, perhaps God's grace and my guru's blessing within me. It has come out through Annamacharya songs only. They became a source of my manodharma. In Bahudhar also, there is one song, Tyagaraja's Prabhuharma, which is a very popular kitra. In that raga, this song, Sakala Shanti Karamu Sarvesha Nipai Bhakti.
ప్రకటమై మాకు నవ్వి బ్రతికించు ఇదియే సర్వేశ మనసులోని పాపబుద్ధి మరి ఎంత దలచిన నిన్ను దలచినంతనే నీరవును కనుగొన్న పాపములు కడలేనివైనాను గనుడ నిన్ను చూచితే కడకు తొలగును కాయమున చేసేటి కర్మపు పాపములెల్ల కాయపు నీ ముద్రల చే గక్కున వీడు ఏ ఎడ వెంకటేశ ఏ పాతకమైనా ఆయమ్మన నీ శరణాగతి చేయననుగు సకల శాంతి కరము సర్వేశ నీపై భక్తి.
ఓకే,
మీరు రెండు లైన్లు, ఒక లైన్
నేనంటా. శాంతి కరము సర్వేశ సగల శాంతి కరము సర్వేశ సగల శాంతి కరము సర్వేశ నిపై భక్తి సగల శాంతి కరము సర్వే Sha Nibai Bhakti Sarvesha Sagala Shanti Karahu Sarvesha Nibai Bhakti Sarvesha Sagala Shanti Karahu. మనసులు పాపబుద్ధి
ఫస్ట్ చరణం
మనసులు పాపబుద్ధి మరి ఎంత దయచేన మనసులు పాపబుద్ధి మరి ఎంత దయచేన నిను దలచీరంతలే నీరమును బుద్ధి మరి ఎంత దయచీన నిను దలచీనందనే నీరము కనుగొన్న పాపము శాంతి కరము సర్వేశ నీపై భక్తి సర్వేశ సగల శాంతి కరము.
ఇలాగ బహుదారి బహుదారులు తొక్కుతుందన్నమాట. అంటే ఒక రాగం హౌ హీ ఈజ్ ఎ క్రాఫ్ట్స్మెన్, హౌ ఆ నగిషి ఎలా చిక్కుతాడంటే ఆయన రాగానికి ది పర్టిక్యులర్ రీజన్ వై నేదునురిస్ కాంపోజిషన్స్ ఆఫ్ అన్నమాచార్యస్ ట్యూన్స్ సర్వైవ్ టు దిస్ డే అండ్ ఆల్సో సంగ్ ఆల్ ఓవర్ ది వరల్డ్ ఎవ్రీవేర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఇన్హెరెంట్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ మ్యూజిక్ ఇన్ దట్. There is another composition. There are many compositions of Annamacharya. You see, the problem a composer faces, like Annamacharya for that matter, his compositions are all on Venkateshwara. If they are on other gods, they are also on Venkateshwara. When he talks about Alamelumanga, he talks about Venkateshwara. He talks about Hanuman, Venkateshwara. Dattatreya, Venkateshwara. Hanuma Venkateshwara, Rama Venkateshwara, Krishna Venkateshwara, whoever it is, they are all Venkateshwara to him. Because for him, all gods can be seen in Venkateshwara. For Bhadrachala Ramadas, he can see all gods in Rama. These are two different kinds of devotees, both of them just separated by about 150 years. Now, the compositions of Annamacharya have a vast variety, but please understand, his theme is only one. One theme, devotion to Venkateshwara, nothing else. And writing 32,000 songs on that. And then, you have to you have to describe, what can you describe in 32,000 psalms as the same theme? So he has vast variety of, you know, dimensions of devotion. In one song he says, Nenokada lekapote ni krupaku patramedi puni navallane kirtinandevuni. In another composition he says, ni gunamu nenu erigi ninnu telusugane teliyaga nera na gunamu ni erigi nannu elukovayya. Very different kind of a composer. Deenudanu nenu devuduvuni purushottamudavivu purushadhamudanenu dharalona na yandu manchitanamedi ananta aparadhamulatu memu jesevi anantamaina dayadi needi. నిన్ను నెరగకుండేటి నీచ గుణము మాది నన్ను నడయకుండేటి గుణము నీది. పురుషోత్తముడవీవు పురుషార్థముడు నేను ధరలోన నాయందు మంచితనమేది. దిస్ ఈజ్ అ సాంగ్ విచ్ విల్ బ్రింగ్ టియర్స్ టు ఎనీబడి హూ హ్యాస్ ఎనీ ఇంట్రెన్సిక్ ఇన్హరెంట్ కాంపోనెంట్ ఆఫ్ 1% ఆఫ్ భక్తి. యూ డోంట్ నీడ్ 100% భక్తి. దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ సాంగ్స్ ది కంపోజర్స్ రైట్ నాట్ బికాజ్ అన్నమాచార్య ఈజ్ ఎ పురుషార్థముడు. ఈ సేస్ పురుషోత్తముడు వీవు పురుషాధముడు నేను. ఈజ్ హీ అన్ ఇన్ఫీరియర్ మ్యాన్ అన్నమాచార్య? నో. పీపుల్ ఆస్క్ మీ వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ నేమ్ అన్నమాచార్య. అన్నం యజ్ఞాంతకృత్ యజ్ఞగుహ్యం అన్నం అన్నాదయే వచ్చ. విష్ణు సహస్రనామం గివ్స్ యూ ది నేమ్ అన్నం. అండ్ అనదర్ థింగ్ హీ హ్యాస్ సచ్ బ్యూటిఫుల్ నేమ్స్ పుట్ టుగెదర్ లైక్ ఎ బ్రదర్ లైక్ ఎన్ ఎల్డర్ బ్రదర్ హీ హోల్డ్స్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్ Like a mother, he treats you. Like a father, he protects you. Anna, Amma, Ayya, Annamayya. The greatness of Annamayya's compositions are reflected in his compositions. But how to sing them? He composes this Purushottama Davivu in a very touching raga, like a Ravagupti raga. And this raga, you know, this raga is used for several other purposes. But the purpose of this raga seems to be only devotion. When you look at this wonderful composition, Purushottamuda vivu purushadhamuda nenu dharalona nayandu manchitanamedi neramantayu nadi nerupantayu nidi sareku ajnani nenu jnani vinivu. This composition, how did he do it in Ravagupti? Why?
Telugu is the mother tongue for Carnatic music, Karnataka. Such a sweet language. And again, Telugu lo oka teepitanam untundi. Dantho musical sweetness kuda join kaliste, really it is a heaven. Amrutam, Sangeeta Amrutam. సంగీతం ఆపాద మధురం సాహిత్యం ఆలోచనామృతం ఉంటారు. బట్ అవర్ గ్రేట్ స్కాలర్స్ హవ్ మేడ్ సంగీతం ఆల్సో ఆలోచనామృతం. ట్రినిటీస్ హ్యావ్ షోన్ ది ట్రెడిషనల్ వాల్యూస్ అండ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ మెలడీ. మెలడీ మీన్స్ technicalities, grammar, and so many aspects. Ocean of music, ocean of classical music, without deviating the traditional. That was their greatness. Tyagaraju, Dikshitar, Shama Shastri. Annamacharya's compositions are, their poetic excellence. They are unparalleled. నభూతం నభవిష్యత్తి వెంకటేశ సమూదేవో నభూతం నభవిష్యత్తిని శాస్త్రం. బట్ అన్నమాచార్య సంకీర్తన నభూతో నభవిష్యత్తి. వాటికి ఎటువంటి మ్యూజిక్ పెట్టాలి? హౌ టు బ్రింగ్ అవుట్ హిస్ భావ? వీ కాంట్ ఇమాజిన్ హిస్ భావ. దట్ పోయిటిక్ ఎక్సలెన్స్ ఈవెన్ గ్రేట్ పోయిట్స్ ఆల్సో ఆర్ ఫైండింగ్ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్స్ క్లియర్. పురుషోత్తముడవేవు పురుషాధముడ నేను. దోస్ హూ నో తెలుగు దే కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వెరీ వెల్ వాట్ హీ సెడ్. వీ కాంట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్. There are no English words for certain Telugu words. Nadam, they say sound. Sound is not nadam. It's a sabda. Nadavidya. So,
ఎందుకు రావగుప్తులో చేశారు?
ఓన్లీ వన్ రిప్లై, యూ మస్ట్ ఆస్క్ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర.
బికాస్ హీ డిడ్ నాట్ రిప్లై, హీ డజన్ రిప్లై టు మీ, మేబీ త్రూ యూ హీ విల్ రిప్లై
ఇన్ సాంగ్ ఓన్లీ, నాట్ ఇన్ వర్డ్స్.
పురుషోత్తమ,
some feeling will come to our mind and heart. So with that raga, in that particular raga, if it is proper, we can convey the meaning properly. Something will tell intuition, some inspiration, some intuition. That's all we can say. Apart from grammar in music, something which we do not know, inside there will be some intuition, inspiration, God given gift, that's all. With that, something prompted me. Shruti. These are the technical aspects musicians can, they can see. That will be the inspiration.
Purushottamudavivu Purushadhamudeninu.
Some feeling must come out.
Purushadhamudeninu Purushottamudavivu Purushadhamudeninu Dharalode na yendu manchitana veri Purushottamudavivu purushanamude neenu dharalode nayendu manchitename nee purushottamude vi purushanamude neenu. అనంతాపరాధములు అటు నేము చేసేని అనంతాపరాధములు అటు నేము చేసేని అనంతమైన దయ అది నీగణంతావరాధములు అటు నేము చేసేని అనంతమైన దయ అది నీ నిను నెరుగకుండేటి నీచగుణమునది నిను నెరుగకుండేటి నీచగుణమునది నను నెలయకుండేటి గుణము నీది పురుషోత్తముడయవీవు పురుషాధముడి నేను
యాక్చువల్లీ ఆర్ట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వే గ్రేట్ but who can present it in artistic way is more great. The presentation is very important. Presentation, through presentation, any song, any beauty we can spoil. Presentation is very important. Paata teliyadam kada paatam teliyadu kavithun raayadam kada. There are so many poets, they can write but they can't express. Expression is very important. So artist must know first expression, then the art. That is the real art. So expression will bring lot of success. There are so many artists, they are vidwans, but they can't present it in an artistic way. One must see the art in that, the beauty in the art. Then only it is art, otherwise it has become science. It's very important.
That brings me to another dimension of Nedunuri's personality. Nedunuri's personality as a musician, he has a style. And what is his style? I find, because of my association with him and association with the field of music for the last so many years, I see number one, his style. He has inherited from his guru, Sangeet Kalanidhi, Sripada Pinakapani, who is, as he says rightly, he is the Dronacharya for several Akalavyas in this country. He is the only one who wrote these four volumes of Sangeet Saurabham with all the notation. And he has also written a book on Manodharma Sangeetam, which now nobody tries to dare to write a book on Manodharma Sangeetam. That being his disciple, he has inherited his qualities of music, his style of rendering. But I would say that because what happens, I don't want to bring comparisons, but I would like to only add to this that he has innovated, created, conceived his own style based on his association with 70 years of music field, in the field of music. 70 years he knows lots of musicians. He has If for him Lalgudi Jairaman played violin, Araikudi Ramanujam was, he has seen him, he has heard him. GNB has seen him, has heard him. ML Vasant Kumar has seen him, heard him. His compositions are sung by MS Subbalakshmi. And he has also been, you know, associated with, initially, he learned music from Dwaram Narasingharao Naidu. Dwaram Narasingharao Naidu is the brother's son of Dwaram Venkateswami Naidu. And Dwaram Narasingharao Naidu, very fortunately, I also knew him and we used to play in his house actually. This
actually,
place...
Sorry. Actually, if at all there is any greatness in my music, the credit goes to my Guruji only. He is a Bhishmacharya. He has given... I could imbibe some knowledge, very little. And the presentation aspect, how to sing, what is to be presented, the Tamil Nadu Rasikas have taught me. Really. And my accompanist, always Lalgudi is my violinist, my accompanist. And Palghat Raghu or Umyalpuram Shivaraman, even Palghat Maniyaran, Nandikeshwar, he also played for 4 or 5 concerts. So they taught me how to present. So presentation, as I told you, is a different aspect, an important aspect. How to present? What is to be presented? Actually, what the audience wants, to what extent they can digest. There are very great Vidwans. Unfortunately, they do not know how to present. Science has to be studied, art has to be presented.
Also, I find that he has a special way of elaboration of ragas. You might have already seen him in the last 2 compositions that he rendered. There is a way that he presents a raga. And the raga, when he presents it, it comes in its full form in front of you. And you can see all the notes very distinctly, you can see, identify the notes and see the sampurna swarupam of the raga in front of you. That is another nature. And also, I have seen him that even when his voice doesn't cooperate, he is always Shruti Shuddham man. That is another dominant qualification. Coming back to his Annamacharya's compositions, Annamacharya, as I said, wrote about, out of 14,000 that we have, 12,000 are Sringara Sankirtana. And his Sringara Sankirtana should be viewed from a different point of view. They are not Sringara Sankirtana from the physical point of view. The physical level is a very mundane level. We should go beyond that. The reason why I say this is, his guru is Alamelumanga. First guru of Annamacharya is Alamelumanga. When he was 16, as he was walking uphill, he fainted. And then an old lady comes, in the disguise of an old lady, Alamelumanga comes to him and tells him, these mountains, these hills, these rocks here, this bush here, are all sages and rishis and saints. This hill is full of saligramas. Remove your shoes and walk up there. So he did that. When he looked around, she was not around. So there that is the only place in the 32,000 songs, that is the only place where he mentions his name. Because he was just 16 and he did not yet compose any songs except the one that when he was sleeping and got in dream and got up, he put it to Kalaganti Nella Lokamulaku, Appadagu Tiruvenkatadri Shiganti, Atishayam Bayana Sashadri Shikarmaganti, Pratileni Gopura Prabhalaganti, Chatakoti Surya Tejamulu Velugaganti, Chaturashya Vadaganti, Chayana Meluganti. He got up. When he walked up the hill, when she is not found anywhere, he said, అమ్మకు తాళ్లపాక గనుడన్నడు పద్యశతంబు చెప్పి శేకొమ్మని వక్ప్రసూనముల కురిమితో నలిమేలు మంగకు నెమ్మది నీవు చేకొని అనేక యుగమ్ములు భక్తకల్పములు సమ్మదమంది వర్ధిలుము జవ్వని లీలల వెంకటేశ్వర. దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ వెరీ అన్యూజువల్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ పోయమ్. ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ గో ఇన్ టు ది లిరికల్ బ్యూటీస్ నౌ బికాస్ వీఆర్ ట్రయింగ్ టు లిజన్ టు నేదునూరిస్ మ్యూజిక్. బట్ దిస్ పోయమ్ ఆల్సో ఇస్ అడ్రస్ టు వెంకటేశ్వర. దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ అలమేలు మంగ. దిస్ 100 పోయమ్స్ ఆర్ అబౌట్ అలమేలు మంగ. But the Makutam is Venkateshwara, that's the kind of devotion he has. And the kind of Chrungara Sankirtanas he has, there are 2 songs I would like to mention that Nedunuri has composed music to. One is of course the Amukho Chigruta Dharmana, you have already heard it. The second and third song I would like to mention, apart from many other songs that he has composed, is the one that she woke up in the morning a little late. Alamelumanga woke up a little late in the morning, and the Chelikattulu were thinking, why did she sleep late? Palukutiya Nelatalli Pavalinchan. Kalikitanamuna Vibhuni Kalachinadigana. Kalikitanamuna Vibhuni Kalachinadigana Palukutiya Nelatalli Pavalinchan. Kumbuzarina Maragu Gubbalalayaka Tarani Bangaru Medapai Pavalinchanu Chengaluva Kanugonala Singaramulu Deliya Angajagurini Todalachinadigana. Muripempu Natanato Muchala Malagupai Parvashambuna Tarani Pavalinchanu Tiruvenkatachaladhipuni Kavita Degili Aravirai Nunichamata Antinadigana. This is a wonderful composition. It talks about just a similarity with Maguvatana Kedika Mandiram Vadalana of Kshatraya. This wonderful song is such a very erotic song if you look at it from that point of view. But if you look at it from the point of view of Annamacharya and his description of Alamelumanga after having spent the night with Lord Venkateshwara, it's a beautiful song. And he has composed it in Abhiri. But another song, I would like to go to another song where this is a very unusually wonderful song. When Nedunuri garu said, Annamacharya Sahityam is wonderful. It is beyond the capacity of any person, any scholar, in any poet, in any literature to think in these terms. Palati Javanamu Puvaka Puchi. Look at this composition. Annamacharya equates everything with a flower. Everything of her activities are equated with a flower every time. Palati Javanamu Puvaka Puche is the first flower that is still blossoming. And then Yalami Ninduku Manam Emi Sesede Sati Chinta Alatalache Sampanga Pulu Puche Mati Virahapu Mena Mallelu Puche Athanani Talapotalo Adavijadulu Puche ఇతవు తెలియదిక నేమి చేసేదే తెయ్యలి చెమట నీట దొంతి తామరలు పూచే కొయ్య చూపుల కోపముల కుంకుమ పూచే కయ్యపు వలపుల చీకటి మాకులు పూచే ఇయ్యడ చిలిభావం ఏమి చేసేదే. దట్స్ నాట్ ఎనఫ్. ది థర్డ్ చరణం ఇస్ ఆల్వేస్ వెన్ యూ ట్రస్ట్ ఇన్ ది టూ చరణమ్స్ ఆఫ్ వెంకటేశ్వర యూ షుడ్ గో టు ది థర్డ్ చరణం టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది వండర్ఫుల్ నువాన్సెస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఎక్సలెంట్ సాంగ్. మగువ రతులలోన మంకెన పూలు పూచే ముగి కొనగోళ్లనే మొగిలి పూచే పొగరు శ్రీ వెంకటేశు పొందుల కప్రము పూచే కప్పురము పూచే ఇగురు బోండ్లం ఇంకనేమి చేసేది. దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ బ్యూటిఫుల్ సాంగ్ అండ్ త్యాగరాజా హ్యాస్ ది ఈజ్ ది వన్ కంపోజర్ హూ గేవ్ అస్ ది ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ కరహర ప్రియ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ టోటల్. కరహర ప్రియ ఈజ్ గివెన్ టు అస్ బై త్యాగరాజా బికాస్ హీ హ్యాస్ గివెన్ సో మెనీ కంపోజిషన్ కరహర ప్రియ దట్ హీ టెల్స్ అస్ హౌ టు go into Karhara Priya without deflecting, deviating into another raga and understand the essence of the nuances of the wonderful components of this excellent raga, Karhara Priya. I don't know why, and he will always say, only Lord Venkateshwara gave me this raga. But this Karhara Priya versus Palati Javanam is an excellent combination. If it is done, if Annamaya comes now, he will say, let me say Nedunuri, I will change it into Karhara Priya. That is the beauty of this raga. Can I listen to this song, sir?
Yeah. See that poetic excellence. Nobody can come near Annamacharya. That's why I told you. Nabhuja Unabhishya. In this raga, the first song was Okabari Okabari Vayaram. See the dimensions, difference.
Adi di padu.
Adi. Kogavari, kogavari, koyyaramai. When we sing that line, you must see the oyaram. Kogavari, kogavari, koyyaramai. Mogamuna kallilille molachinattunde okavari kogavari voyyaram mogamuna kallilille molachinattunde
పొలజి జౌవన మున పూవక పూజే దిగపు మాల్. దిస్ ప్రయోగం యూ కాంట్ సీ ఇన్ ఎనీ కాంపోజిషన్. దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ న్యూ ప్రయోగ. పొలజి జౌవన మున పూవక పూజే ఎలమి నిందు మనమి విషే పొలతి జౌన గుణ పూవగ పూచలమి నిందు. దిస్ పర్టిక్యులర్ సంగతి మిస్టర్ మోహన్ రామ మోహన్
రమణన్
ఈజ్ ఎంజాయింగ్ దిట్స్ పర్టిక్యులర్ the sangatis because he is he himself is a musician. He knows the value of technical value also. Yalami nindu ko manami mise se de polati jauna buna tuvaka poche డెస్పరేట్ మూమెంట్లో వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ వీ కెన్ డూ. ఎలమి నిందుకు మనమే మిషే పొలది జవన మున సతి చింతలతలని సంపెంగ పూలు పూచి. సిది లైన్ సతి చింతలతలని సంపెంగ పూలు పూచి మతి విరహపులోన మలిలేలు పూచి. ది రాగా మస్ట్ గివ్ దట్ ఫ్లవర్స్ ఫ్లవర్ దట్ ఈచ్ సంగతి మస్ట్ గివ్ దట్ ఫ్లవర్ బట్ నాట్ మొగరపు. సతి చింతలతలని సంపెంగ పూలు పూచి మది విరహములోన మల్లెలు పూచి అదను నితల పోతను అగను
అగరు అడవి జాజును పూచి
అదను నితల పోతను అడవి జాజును పూచి అదను నితల పోతను అడవి జాగులు పూచి హితము తెలియది కను ఏమి చేసేది పొలతి జౌవన గుణ పూవక పూచి మగువరతులలోన మంగళ పూలు పూచి మొగి కొన్న కోళ్ళ మే మొగలి పూలు పూచి లోన మంగళ పూచి
మొగి కొన్న
కోళ్ళ మే మొగలి పూలు పూచి పొగరు శ్రీ వెంకటేశు pondule kampramu puji mon pangaru sri venkateshu kampramu puji iguru mondlemu inkaye mishi chede iguru mondlemu inkaye mishi chede Kulati chupana muna puvaka puji.
A little aside is,
what I feel, dance is not separate. It's a part of music. Sometimes I feel, when I sing, I could see the dance also in that music. That grace, that beauty. The dance, grace and beauty, if any musician will enjoy at heart, then that artist is entirely different. I will see the dance.
Pogaru Sri Venkatesu Pondule Kampramu Duji Giguru Vandlamu Inkaye Vishesede Kolati Chavana Muna Povaga
Is it not? There is dance. Part of music is dance. Yetam Vajyam Tadhan Pratyam
Lichyanja Trayam Sangeetam
Sangeetam Chitam Sangeetam Loka Bhagam Amkane Natyana Kuda Music Academy Sangeet Kalana Dena Ishtar
Aside is that whenever Nedunuri garu.
So they must learn music.
Musician, dancers should
dancers
learn.
Dancers all should learn. Invariably they must learn music.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Musicians should have knowledge of dance, dancers should have knowledge of music, and both should have knowledge of literature.
Yeah. both should have the audience pulse and the audience taste. That's very important.
SID is, whenever Nedunuri garu does a song like this, composes a song, I was, touched by this generosity of his personality, that he, when he composed this song, he called me from Vishakhapatnam and sang this song to me on phone in Chennai and said, this song, Pappu garu, you will like it. And wherever, whenever anybody does an interview for him in TV or somewhere, he will say, Pappu garu likes this song as one, another.
Pappu garu likes this song.
See, if at all, in about music, people consider, the Sangeet Kalanidhi is almost like a Nobel Prize in music for Carnatic musicians.
Yeah. A supreme recognition for any musician, Sangeet Kalanidhi.
And if I have my way, I would have given him another Sangeet Kalanidhi only for Palati Javanam. Because Nana Tipatku got one already. Now coming back to, we are running short of time. We are at 4:30 now. There are umpteen number of songs which are popular because of Nedunuri. Now look at this Mudugare Yashoda Mungita Uchyama. It is all over the world. And I have seen this composer into dance, as he says, dance reflects music, music reflects dance, and dance is nothing but a moving body which reflects music. So Mudugare Yashoda in Kurunji, that is an outstanding contribution of wonderful composition. Can I just listen to one or two lines?
Once my son has telephoned to me, there was one festival, Tana, the Telugu festival. It seemed there were 20 young girls, they have given dance performance, out of which 18
dancers have performed
Mudugare Yashoda only. So, from Ammalu to Amamma,
No, like this, like this different flowers for Palati Javanamu, you find different gems for Muddugari Yashoda Krishna in all the Navaratnams. Sir. I wanted to show you the different dimensions of Nedunuri's compositions. We have seen one Emukko Chigurita Dharamuna, we have seen Purushottamuda Vivu, a kind of composition which are diametrically opposite in direction. Purushottamuda Vivu, Nanati Bratuku Natakamu, and then Emukko Chigurita Dharamuna, Palukuti Enala Thalli, Palati Javanamu, Muddugare Yashoda. He has, like Annamacharya said,
Palukuti Enala Thalli. Current line
Minpidha. Palukutya Nala Thalli, we need to listen to at least two lines definitely
because
this is a very different kind of a composition. So we'll just listen to that and then go to Ramadas next.
Once Lakshmi Vishwanathan has given a lecture demonstration, then she said new songs entered into dance. So this was the one of the songs. Dance in music again. Adi
Palukuti Nela Thalli Pavadinchenu Palukuti Nela Thalli Pavadinchenu Palukuti Nela Thalli Pavadinchenu Kaligitanamula Vibhuni Galashiredi Gana Palukuti Nela Thalli Kaligitanamula Vibhuni Galashinadi Gana Palukuti Nela Thalli Pavadinchenu Nigandi gandi mohamupai Merulu gela kunai chadarani gali gali bhupai nelulu gela gula chadara pagalai nada kanchili pavali janmu gali gali bhupai nelulu gela gula chadara pagalai nada kanchili pavali janmu గలి పరిణతు గలి పరిణతులతో తెల్లవారి నగలి పరిణతులతో తెల్లవారి నగలి పరిణతులతో తెల్లవారి నంద జగదేకపతి మనసు జగదేకపతి మనసు జగతిని గన పలుకుతే నెలగతల్లి పవణి చెందు కలిగితన మూల విభూతి గలసినది గన పలుకుతే నెలగతల్లి చెను తల్లి పవలిన్ చెను తల్లి పవలిన్ 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 చెను
పవలించను చెప్పినప్పుడు లేవకుండా పాడాలన్నమాట. నిగ నిగని మోమితో మోముపై నెరులు గలకులు చెదర పగలైన దాకా చెలి పవళించను తెగని పరిణతులతో తెల్లవారిన దాకా జగదేకపతి మనసు జట్టిగొనగాన పలుకుతేనెల తల్లి పవళించను. ఆ సాహిత్యం దట్ సంగీతం దే షుడ్ గో టుగెదర్ అండ్ ఎక్సల్ ఈచ్ అదర్. ఇఫ్ దేర్ ఇస్ అ కాంపిటీషన్ దట్ ఈస్ బిట్వీన్ ది సాహిత్యం అండ్ సంగీతం, నథింగ్ నోవేర్ ఎల్స్. అండ్ దాట్ ది బ్యూటీ ఆఫ్ కాంపోజిషన్స్ దట్ హీ హ్యాస్ రెండర్డ్ హీ కంపోజ్ ఫర్ అన్నమాచార్య. అన్నమాచార్య ఈవెన్ దో హీ రోడ్ 32,000 ఈ సేస్ ఐ డోంట్ రైట్ ఎనీథింగ్, నా నాలికపై నుండి నానా సంకీర్తనలు పుని నాచే నిన్ను పగడించితివి, వేనామాల వెన్నుండా వినితింప నేనెంతవాడ కానిమ్మని నాకు ఈ పుణ్యము గట్టితి వింతేనయ్యా. దట్స్ వాట్ హీ సేస్, దట్స్ వాట్ హీ సేస్ ఆల్సో. అండ్ దెన్ వీ గో ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ టు అనదర్ వండర్ఫుల్ కంపోజర్ భద్రాచల రామదాస్. భద్రాచల రామదాస్ ఇస్ అనదర్ వెరీ హైలీ పిక్యులర్ కంపోజర్ విత్ జస్ట్ అబౌట్ 152 సాంగ్స్. The maximum number of songs that you can attribute to, including attributions and interpolations, don't cross 152. And his compositions are basically divided into before he went to the prison, during the prison, and after he was released. 12 years of rigorous imprisonment for what he did. Itvaku kulatilaka ikanayana polukave Ramachandra sitammaku cheyisti chintaku patakam aa patakamunaku patte 10,000 varahalu. Ramachandra gives an account of how he spent the money. And he considers Rama of Bhadrachalam only, not another Rama of another temple as his God. This is called Ananya Bhakti, Advitiya Bhakti. Eka Ananya Mamata Vishnu Mamata Prema Sangata Punarvislesha Bhirutvam Parama Bhakti Ruchyate. These are the two things that Narada Bhakti Sutra says. And he also wrote Dasaradi Shatakam. We have very fortunately Nedunuri garu composed music for the Dasari Chatkam poems as well as 54 of Ramadas' compositions. As I said, I keep saying that Bhadrachal Ramadas is not his name. Bhadrachalam ayana inti peru kadu, Ramadas ayana peru kadu. Ayana peru Kancherla Gopan. He is a composer who just, you know, his name is also forgotten. His real name is forgotten, is known to the world as Bhadrachal Ramadas. And he says, Chakkaramani, Vemudina Zalina Kaivadi Manavadhamul Pekkur Bakka Daivamala Vemarugul Turatlu Gadaya Mukkina Nikumakka Vale Matrama Sangina Neva Evalan Takkina Matala Emitiki Dasharadhi Karunapuram. And he is such a wonderful composer. And you find the kind of Karuna, Bhakti, Ardrata in all his compositions. And luckily, fortunately, I would like to understand from Nedunuri garu why, after going deep into Annamacharya's compositions, why did he have to come out and compose for Ramadas? Ramadas, why at all?
The ultimate goal is moksha only, then only bhakti is required. Annamacharya was very young. So Srungaram Aparam Srungaram Chakapram Moksham Dhani Venu. Why is I think? So, this is another outlook. We see the bhakti only. We cannot, the scope is not there to create our own imaginations and everything. We must convey the bhakti, the devotion towards God. Ultimately, devotion is important to achieve the goal of life. And dedication towards our profession is the main reason for success. Success is not goal. Goal is entirely different. Devotion is very important to achieve the goal. Ramadasa, he was given a place along with Narada, Parashara, Prahlada. Ramadasa, Tyagaraja has given to Ramadasa Narada, Prahlada, Parashara,
Ramadasadu.
Bhaktagriganyullo Ramadasa kanta plesiccha.
Even in Kshirasagara Sena also he says, Dhirudav Ramadasana Brochinadi Vinanurai. There are four compositions of Tyagaraja where Tyagaraja mentions Ramadasa along with Prahlada, Parachara, Narada and others. And Kaligumana Varabhadrachala Ramadasu, he starts in Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam also, the Pitika Pajyams, he describes Ramadas. And we understand from Tyagaraja's history that Tyagaraja was influenced by Ramadas and his mother used to sing Ramadas compositions.
Yes.
That being so,
Meeru
maatanaru ayaniki pedda srungaram teliyadani, ayaniki teliyadu anukodaniki veelledu. Ekanta Ramadasu, he says, he sang only two or three songs with Sitamma. Because he was a tashildar, he knows how to approach the boss. So he approaches her through Rama with through Sita. He says, Adrija Vinitudu Bhadragirishudu Nidra Melkonu Vela Nelatoro Bodhinchi Nanu Brahmani Chappave Pakkaku Cheri Chekkili Nokkutu Chakkaga Maruki Edi Srukki Yendedi Vela Nanu Brahmani Chappave Sitamma Talli. Master, after the composition that you composed, Ramajogi Mandu in Khamas, why Khamas again?
Ramadas ku teliyadani kaadu, koncham sikkupaddadu cheppadani. Annamacharya laga, ayana acharyudu kada. Ante
Ramajogi Mandu padtara?
Ramajogi Mandu.
Ramajogi Mandu Khamas. Ramayya Bhadrachala Rama, Ravayya Bhadrachala Rama, Ramajogi Mandu or Etiruga, whatever composition.
It is just
and I want at least one or two padyams, like, you know, Bhupala Lama or Ramudu Ghorapataka Viramudu. Some of those padyam, one padyam probably, and then one song.
I am not able to control myself without telling the fact that Krishna Mohan garu is responsible to
bring all these compositions and to introduce. I have tuned it, but he has brought it.
And this gentleman has been doing Ramadas Jayanti every year in Badrachal. He hosts about 1,000 people, 1,500 people for 4 days, 5 days. All their food accommodation is taken care of by him. Not only that, he gives tickets to some people, and also some honorarium to some people. That kind of a bhakta is Krishnamurthy garu, and his son-in-law there, Vijay Kumar. All these people have reinvented Ramadas's compositions again. And we have, I and Nedunuri garu, we went to Badrachalam February 12th, where we have done this Ramadas Jayanti. You should see to believe how in Tiruvayar Pancharatnam Sarsang, he has done. Another thing that I want to bring to your notice is that like Tyagaraja's Pancharatnas, he was also instrumental in Saptagiri Sankirtanas of Annamacharya. Then he has composed 9 compositions of Ramadasa, and Ramadasa Jayanti day all 9 are sung in Goshtigan. And I have asked him why 9, and I gave the answer myself. The answer is because Rama was born on Navami, he has taken 9 compositions. And that is how these 9 compositions are sung in Goshtiganam. And you should see how this 85-year-old man behaves like a 25-year-old man and sings along with other people.
Rama's grace.
Rama jogi bandhu konare, bojenula ra. Rama jogi bandhu konare, bojenula ra. Rama jogi bandhu konare, bojenula ra. Rama jogi bandhu konare, bojenula. Rama jogi mantu konare, o jenule re. Rama jogi mantu konare, o jenule re. Rama jogi mantu konare. Rama jogi bandhu niruyu, Rama jogu jinjaraya. Rama jogi bandhu miru, Rama jogu jinjaraya. Rama jogi bandhu miru, Rama jogu jinjaraya. Kama krodha mula nella kadagu varadrole mandu, kama krodha mula nella kadagu varadrole mandu. Rama jogi mandu konare, o jenule re. Rama jogi mandu konare. Prema to Badrachala mandu, Prema to Badrachala mandu, Kaminchiyunnati mandu, Prema to Badrachala. Ramadasu hridaya mandu, Prema to Badrachala mandu, Ramadasu hridaya mandu, Kaminchiyunu natti sri. Rama mantra maina mandu, Kaminchiyunu natti sri. Rama mantra maina mandu, Rama jogi mandu konare, o jenule re. Rama jogi mandu konare.
You know, bhajana sampradayam adyudina I was told by
Udayalur
Kalyan Raman, one of the greatest exponent in Bhajana Sampradaya, he said, they begin Sampradaya Sangi, Bhajana with Ramadas
in Tamil Nadu.
That was the place, Ramadas in Tamil Nadu. They sing more than 100 songs in that Sampradaya Bhajana. So that was the place of Ramadasu and a full of devotion, Amrutam.
Some people ask me, sir, we don't have the music of Annamacharya, we don't have the music of Ramadas, can we really call them Vagyakaras? Modern trends, you know, research scholars will ask questions like that. And then I tell them, you take just one composition of Annamacharya, Bhavayami Gopala Balam. Read this as a prose only. Don't read poetry into that. Don't read a lyric into that. Kati gatita mekala kachita mani gantika patalanana deena vibhrajamanam kutila padagatita sankula sinjitena tam chatula natana samujjala vilasam bhavayami gopala bala. There is inherent music in that. A Vagyakara can only write like that. And Vagyakara is not the one just to write the lyric and the compose music to it. There are so many other qualities. Chanda Prabheda Veditvam, Alankare, Shukauchalam, Shastra Jnanam, Kalavi, Deshistitu Chaturi, Kakuswara Vidhanam, Ragadvesha Varjitam. There are hundreds of other qualifications. Similarly, if you take Bhadrachal Ramadas, even in his poems, one of his poems he says, Bhandana Bhimud Artha Jana Bhandavud Ujjvala Bhanatuna Kodanda Kalaprachanda Bujitandava Kittiki Ramamuttiki and Rendavasati Devimukh Ledan Sun Gadagatti Berika Danda 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 Nanadambula Jandamun and Damattave Dandamunikki Chata Danda Charadi Karuna Payone. That is the kind of inherent music they have in their compositions, and it is natural. It is very wonderful that we have composers of music, particularly a person who has lived in music for over 70 years, composing music to such compositions. I am coming to 5 o'clock, so I am trying to wind up. But before I wind up, I have a temptation, an irresistible temptation, to ask him something. This one is a very special question because he is a special man. And the special question is, we know compositions, composers like Tyagaraja are born once in a yugam. And he is an outstanding composer. And very fortunately or unfortunately, 12 of his compositions were not composed to music by him. And these were available in manuscripts in the Saurashtra Library in Madurai. Akella Mallikarjuna Sharma and Veturi Anandamurthy. They brought them out and brought them to Nedunuri garu. Nedunuri garu is fortunately the only composer of music who composed music even to Tyagaraja's composition. Can I just listen to one line of that? Pahi.
Oh, but the Indian.
Pahi Paramadayalo copy raga. Any song of your choice.
Muthiyala Chavukulo meeku vachuna. Edi padandi. Okka line anandi.
Em ragam cheppandi.
Hamir Kalyan. Raga was mentioned.
Ayana cheppina ragamlo chesina paatalu. Annamacharya, he has not composed necessarily on the ragas mentioned by him. Because some of these compositions, we don't know even the names of the ragas today. But Tyagaraja, he has adhered to the ragas prescribed by him.
Muthiyala Chavukulo. Muthiyala Chavukulo. Mudala Meeragalo. Muthiyala Chavukulo. Mudala Meeragalo. Kathyavanto.
Yeah.
Look at the variations. When he composes Annamacharya, he is a different Nedunuri. When he composes Ramadas, he is a Nedunuri Ramadas. And then he comes Nedunuri Chagaraju now. Let's see another compositions of Chagaraju. Mm. Pahi Dipi, Dina Dayalu. Paramadaya, Pahi Paramadaya, copy.
Pahi Paramadaya. Hare Mam Pahi Parama Dayalu, Hare Mam Pahi Parama Dayalu, Hare Mam Pahi Parama Dayalu, Hare Mam Pahi Sundaranan Mukundaraghava Sundaranan Mukundaraghava Purandaraghava Sundaranan Mukundaraghava Purandaraghava Pahi Parama Dayalu Nagasayana Bhavaroganashika Sadagati jayahita tyagarajanuta Nagasheyana bhavaroganashika Sadagati jayahita tyagarajanuta Pahi Parama Pahi Parama Dayalu Hare Hare Mam Pahi Parama Dayalu Hare
I can go on asking questions. Here is an ocean. Vanajabhavundu nenasaravarasena sammu ganambo kunchemo. Vinu marubhumi kerigina labhinchunu merugu charabhoyinan danak maadhi adhikam buradu. Avvananiti nutadulyamuga varigrahinchu ghatambu chudumantadu bhartruhari. Oka chembu pattukelthe chembu nille vastayi. Bucket pattithe bucket nille vastayi. Manam enta sepu adigithe anta sepu cheppadaniki ayana siddhanga unnadu. Oka mahanubhavudaina oka దిగ్దిగంత కీర్తి విశ్రాంతి కలిగినటువంటి ఒక మహానుభావుడు ఒక సంగీత కళానిధి నేదునూరి కృష్ణమూర్తి గారు. ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు కంక్లూడ్ ఇట్ విత్ అ రిక్వెస్ట్ టు హిమ్. యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ మెసేజ్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్. ఎస్,
సెంట్రల్ యూనివర్సిటీ here, I wish that
there should be a music department.
There is a dance department. About the music department, of course I like it too. But to create a chair for Tyagaraja, that's my impact. Because he was the Jagat Guru for music. Through Sangeetam, Tangeetam, he has given world Sangeet Jagat Guru. That Sampradaya we must keep up and preserve. It's very important. And there is a lot to be done. Tyagaraja project, it's a vast subject. Research scholars are important. Practical musicians, that is to be preserved. Because nowadays I was told that Tyagaraja Kirtanas not properly on active circulation on this platform in Madras. So it's our ultimate duty to preserve and propagate. They are singing, so many composers have come and they are singing. Previously I know they were all orthodox musicians. They used to sing only Tyagaraja Kirtana. They used to give a lot of importance for Tyagaraja Kirtana only. Tyaga Brahma, Papa Venkatramayya, he doesn't have belief in God. He says only Tyagaraja is God. That was their devotion towards Tyagaraja. So Tyagaraja, I earnestly request the Pro Vice Chancellor Haribabu garu. You create a chair for Tyagaraja. There is a lot to be done. We must preserve his musical tradition, musical heritage. That will be the anywhere from world, throughout the world, from anywhere. If anybody wants Tyagaraja's musical tradition,
they must come
to Hyderabad Central University.
Thank you, Guru Garu. See, his Guru is 100 plus. We wish Nedunuri Garu to follow his footsteps and live longer years, many more years with health and contribute to the field of music.